Having plants in your house can bring great benefits to your interior setting, and also can keep your air much cleaner than it normally is. The first thing when you decide that you want house plants is to make sure you pick the right variety. Plants have different lighting requirements, meaning different plants live better in areas that have different levels of natural light, such as a plant that would live in a den in the corner with a lamp may not necessarily live on a patio that gets full sun all the time. And I've got two varieties that I'll show you as an example. This is a Janet Craig. It's in the Dracaena family. It requires low light. It would not live as good if it was on a sun porch. The opposite of that is this Arbicola. It lives in an area normally where you have high light. If you try to make either one of these varieties live in an area where they would not normally like to live, they would probably make it, but it's going to cause problems in trying to keep them alive, and they're not going to grow very well. So the first thing you want to do is make sure that you have a plant living in an area where it's going to have the natural light that it needs, or you can supplement that particular area by putting a grow light in. The next thing you want to do is make sure you keep your moisture levels proper. A plant will use the amount of water relative to the amount of light it gets. So what does that mean? If it's in a dark corner, it's not going to use a lot of light because it's not going to want to generate a lot of energy because it's going to be sitting in a dark area. The opposite of that would be this Arbicola here. If you have it in a highlight area, it's going to use a lot more water because it's going to want to produce a lot more energy. One of the things it needs to produce that energy is water and, of course, light. So the more light you have, the more water you're probably going to need to put on the plant, and the less light you have, the less water you're probably going to need to put on the plant. But the way you can determine if you're keeping your moisture levels properly in your plants, it's just simply pulling the foliage back and check the soil. Put your finger in the soil. If it seems moist, this plant here is living in a commercial greenhouse setting, so it stays evenly moist all the time because it has plenty of light in here. So you want to make sure a plant like this, the moisture level would be a little bit lower than you would on an ongoing basis than a plant like this that requires a lot of high light and also would require a lot of water. The other thing that you want to watch for when you're maintaining your plants in your house is insects. Typically a plant like this and this Arbicola here, two of the most common varieties of insects you would see would be a spider mite. Normally on this type plant is the most common insect that you would see, and you can when you see foliage like this, it's light green, it's nice and healthy. When you start seeing little white spots on it, you look on the back and you'll see little white spots on it as well, or you may see a spider web. It's going to be a spider mite. If they're left untreated, they will make the plant turn light green and basically suck all the life out of it. The other variety of insect that we see a lot of times is the mealybug. You'll typically find it right in the area here of the plant, and they like to live in highlight areas. Mainly what they'll do is very similar to what a spider mite will do. They'll suck the life out of the plant, not as visible as you would see sometimes like a spider mite. They're going to look mainly like big chunks of cotton in your plant. You can treat these fairly easy. It's good to catch it very early before it spreads on this plant or anywhere else in your house. But you can go to like a garden center or your local farmer's co-op and describe to them what you're having, the problem that you're seeing, and they can suggest something to treat it. But again, it's best to catch it early on. But if you're properly maintaining your plants, then you're going to catch it before it becomes a big problem. The other thing you want to do is when you are maintaining your plants, typically keep the plant rotated on an ongoing basis so the light, if it's getting light from one particular area in the room or like from the one particular side of a sun porch, keep it turned so it will evenly grow because the plant's going to grow toward the light. Those are just a few things that you can do to make sure that you maintain your interior plants in your house properly, and they will live a long time.